So, and then he says, في يوم الاثنين من شهر الأغر في ثالث الشهر أو الثاني عشر. On Monday in the blessed day of Rabi' month of Rabi' al-Awwal, the third of the month or the 12th month, you'll get 8, 9, 10, 12. There's different opinions. The dominant and strongest opinion, it was on the 12th. And that's what, it's a national holiday in every single country, Muslim country, with the exception of one. But all the other Muslim countries have it as a national holiday to celebrate the Prophet's birthday. And historically, it was celebrated with great fanfare throughout the Muslim world. The fact that the Mawlid has died down so much is, I think, a very bad sign, in fact, in the Muslim Ummah. That's my personal opinion. The Mawlid was an immense time of feeding people, of feeding the poor, of charity, of reading the seerah, of reading the shama'il, reciting qasa'id, writing poems, delivering poems, visitations. It was a big time because people just felt the blessing of the Prophet, particularly in that month. But the Mawlid is celebrated throughout the year by people that celebrate the Mawlid. So it's not that they don't just celebrate it on Rabi' al-Awwal or the 12th, but literally we'll recite it. It's very beautiful to recite the Mawlid, and Barzanji's is certainly probably the best and most authoritative. Imam al-Kattani, which is the Moroccan Mawlid, has a beautiful Mawlid also recited in Morocco. But it's something that you really want your children exposed to, the Mawlid. It's important to celebrate the birthday of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The Mawlid, if anybody tells you that it's a bid'ah, well, Surah Maryam is basically a Mawlid because it's relating the story of how Jesus was born. And that's what the Mawlid is doing. It's just you relate the story of how the Prophet ﷺ was born. That's all it is. It's looking at his story and celebrating it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, and then he said, أولي ثمانين من ربيع الأول موافق النيسان عند الأولي. So, a weaker opinion holds it was the 8th day of Rabi' al-Awwal, which corresponds to the month of April according to the scholarly premieres. في عام حظ من سنير الأسكندري بطارع الجدي وكان المشتري مع زحل في وسط السماء تقارن بالعقرب الغراء. So this was around 800 years after Alexander the Great, the sun being in the constellation of Aries. So he was born when the sun was in the constellation. That's what they call in astrology a sun sign. He was born when the sun was in the constellation of Aries. While Jupiter and Saturn were both in the middle of the sky in conjunction with the spectacular constellation Scorpio. So the Jupiter and Saturn were in the constellation of Scorpio. These are planets. This canon Mushtari. Okay, we did that. Any other question? Mm-hmm. Well, they celebrated his being every day and every, I mean, they didn't have any particular, no, there's no doubt that it was a later innovation in terms of doing it on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. There's no doubt that is a bid'ah to do that. Now, depending on the school, bid'ah is not all bad. And that's the dominant school of the ulama, is that there are bid'ah hasana. من سن في الإسلام سنة حسنة فله أجرها وأجر من عمل بها. Whoever does a good sunnah in Islam, he has a reward for it. The Prophet also said, من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. The hadith of Aisha that Imam Nawawi relates that whoever introduces into the religion what is not from the religion, then it's rejected. So the Mawlid celebration of the Prophet's birthday, for instance, a man asked in the Sahih collection, a man asked the Prophet about fasting on Monday, and he said, Fihi wudittu. That's his answer. It's a good day. It's a blessed day. I was born on that day. We know that in the Sahih collection also that Abu Lahab, his punishment is actually lessened because he freed Thawaba on his the girl that brought him the news of the Prophet's birthday was freed. Abu Lahab was so happy that his brother had a son that he said, you're free, anti hurra. So he freed the girl. And the Prophet said, because of that, because of his being happy of the Prophet's birthday, which is why, don't say I don't celebrate the birthday. Because that's actually, that could be kufr. Just, the Prophet said, people will say, رُبَّ أَحَدِكُمْ يُلْقِي يَتَكَلَّمُ بِكَلِمَةٍ لَا يُلْقِي لَهَا بَالَ. Maybe one of you will say a word, he doesn't think of what it really means. وَتَجُرُّهُ فِي جَهَنَّمَ سَبْعِينَ خَرِيفًا. It will drag him in the hellfire for 70 years. Because he doesn't think of what it means. So to say, I don't celebrate the birthday of the Prophet, I would have been deaf. I mean, what do you mean you don't celebrate his birthday? You have to. It's a fard to be happy he was born. If you don't celebrate it on that specific day, on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal, well, that's fine. That's a khilaf issue. The dominant opinion is it's permissible and mandub to do it. It's recommended. The other opinion is that it's an innovation and it's better not to do it, which is a valid opinion. The problem is we accept their differences, they don't accept our differences. So what can we do about it? Mm-hmm. I don't have any, I mean personally we celebrate the Mawlid. We celebrate it throughout the year though, not just specifically on the 12th. I mean I celebrate all the time. I read the, this is a Mawlid right here. I read it all the time. So I'm happy every day. Hello, Akbar. Happy birthday, Ya Rasulullah. Wallahi, I'm happy. I mean, alhamdulillah, I'm happy he was born every day of my life. Wallahi, I'm really happy. I don't need the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal to be happy about it, but when the 12th is there, it's really nice too. So it's all good. فيه عليه الله صلى أبدا. He died in the mid-morning time on the same day he was born. So he died on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. It's the time he made hijrah at the beginning of Rabi' al-Awwal, but he arrived in Medina on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. So that day is a very blessed day. There's no doubt about it. Imam al-Wanshirisi has a fatwa in the Mi'yar that it is by far the greatest day, even more than the Laylatul Qadr. But that most of the ulama say tawaqqaf on that one, that don't, you know. But there are many ulama that wrote fatwas. In the book of Tawqeet that I studied of Ibn Abi Maqra', which is the Moroccan book of orology, the sacred science of timekeeping, like learning how to tell the shadows and the days of the year, the star rising, so that you can keep calendrical sacred time. He just states that it's like ijma, that there's no khilaf about it, that the day he was born is the best day in the history of the world. So that's how it's presented in those, you know, medieval texts, the later texts. In the early period, I think, I haven't seen any of that, but that's what the later scholars make mention of. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, but there's no doubt it's a blessed day.